Welcome. In this video, we will discuss about the latest topic of contempt of court. So very recently, the Supreme Court has filed a contempt of court complaint against the Prashant Bhushan because of his tweet regarding the present Chief Justice of India as well as the previous Chief Justice of India. So because of it, there has been a case of contempt of court against Prashant Bhushan. So now let's try to understand what exactly is contempt of court, what kind of provisions are there in constitution, what all powers does the Supreme Court, High Court has in terms of that, and what are the basic issues in terms of using the power of contempt of court. So let's begin this video. So first of all, we should know about the constitutional provision. A very important thing that you should know is that the constitutional provision says that the expression contempt of court, that is nowhere mentioned in the constitution. So if there is a question in which they ask whether contempt of court as a word, as an expression, is there in the constitution, the answer would be no. So the definition of contempt of court as an expression is nowhere present in the Indian constitution. Now, what is present in the Indian constitution? So if you say there are few articles through which the Supreme Court and High Court could exercise its power. So the first one is your Article 198. So Article 129. So Article 129 is the one which grants Supreme Court the power to punish the contempt of itself. So when there is a contempt of Supreme Court by anybody, the power which is drawn by Supreme Court is from the Article 129. Now, Article 142, Clause 2 also enables the Supreme Court to investigate and punish. Now, they can also launch an investigation and punish any person for its contempt. So, this power comes from Article 142, Clause 2. Now, the High Court derives such kind of power from Article 215. So this power is generated from 215. Now, can you tell me what Article 216 of High Court has? So basically, Article 216 of High Court talks about the writ jurisdiction of High Court. So when you are actually going through these articles, you don't exactly have to remember the article, like the entire constitution, but few articles are very important and they will help you to enrich your answer while writing in mains. So it's important that you remember few articles here and there. So these are the basic constitutional provision by which the courts derive its power of contempt of court. Now the procedure is defined by the Contempt of Court Act of 1971. So in 1971, an act is enacted in which they have provided the procedure or the definition of contempt. So basically, what do you understand by contempt? So contempt is basically nothing but showing disrespect to the court. So it's like if you are not following its jurisdiction, if you are saying something bad about it, then all these things come under the definition of contempt of court. Now, in this particular act of 1971, they have divided the contempt in two types, like in civil contempt as well as criminal contempt. Now, try to understand what is civil contempt. Civil contempt is nothing but when somebody is disobeying the judgment. Judgment could be in the form of like judgment itself, decree or writ. Anything, anyone, if they are not following the orders of Supreme Court, High Court or subordinate court, they will come under the category of civil contempt. Now in the present, like the news which you have been seeing today, it was related to the criminal contempt. Now what is criminal contempt? See the basic words which has been given and defined in 1971 Act. The first one they talk about is scandalizing the court. Now, if you are talking about court in the bad light or scandalizing the whole thing by which it could undermine the authority of court, so that kind of act will come under the criminal contempt. Another thing which could be considered as a criminal contempt is when you are interfering in the course of judicial proceeding itself. Like when the court is still in trial, when there are certain things, investigation is going on or the date is underdue, you are interfering in that process itself, then it also comes under the category of criminal contempt. also when you are going with the judicial proceeding or obstructing the administration of justice. So like for the demand of justice itself, if you are doing something, if you are circulating false information or something like that, that could also come under the category of criminal contempt. So 1971 Act defines what is contempt and divide the contempt into civil and criminal. Now, one very important thing to remember over here is it does not consider innocent publication and distribution of some matter or even fair and reasonable criticism as contempt of court. So the innocent publication, like when you are talking about the judgments, what kind of judgment they are given, and even fair and reasonable criticisms of the judgment could not be considered as a contempt of court. For an example, the court has given judgments on right to privacy, on your Aadhaar Act. So when you see articles in your Hindu and when people are talking about what is good about it, what more could have been done, so that kind of thing cannot be considered as a contempt of court. So these are few facts that you have to remember in terms of what is Constitution is defining and what is specifically mentioned in 1971 Act. Now also see what kind of punishing power does the courts have under this particular contempt of court provision. So the Supreme Court and High Court both can punish either with a simple imprisonment up to 6 months, or they can also lay a fine of rupees 2000 or could be both. So they have the power to imprison for 6 months as well as put a fine. Now, in 1991, Supreme Court has also ruled that it has power to punish for contempt of not only itself but also High Court, subordinate court and tribunals functioning in the entire country. So if there is a question in and one of the statement is, does the Supreme Court has the power to pass contempt of court for the cases of tribunals, the answer would be yes. So that particular statement is correct. It has power to declare the contempt of court for tribunals, for subordinate court, for the High Court or any other courts which is functioning within the entire country of India. So now, but this kind of thing has been done from the 1991 case order. High Court specifically has this power to punish for contempt of court of subordinate court, and that is defined in the Contempt of Court Act of 1971. So if you see what is the difference, basically the Supreme Court can actually punish for other court contempt, but that is through ruling, its own ruling in 1991. On the other hand, High Court has a special power to go for the contempt of court and punish people for the contempt of court of subordinate courts, and that power is defined in the 1971 Act. So that's the difference. Supreme Court has got its power from its ruling, while the 1971 Act has specifically identified and given the power to High Court to punish people for contempt of subordinate court. So these are the basic powers and provisions for this. Now let's also try to understand what is the present issue. The judges could use the contempt of court power to an arbitrary extent, and it could become a problem for people to actually criticize. Now this comes in the contradiction of what is defined in the Article 19 Clause 1. So Article 19, which is like the fundamental right, Clause 1 defines that every citizen of India had the right to freedom of speech and expression. Now when you go for the contempt provision, you can see that the speech and expression itself has been curbed. And one more thing you have to remember is that this kind of thing has been enacted through an act and was not present in the Constitution itself, that what could be considered as a criminal contempt and what could be considered as a civil contempt. Also, an important factor to understand is the law is very subjective. So here, the people who feel that they have been the contempt has been done against them are the judge and the jury. So this actually becomes a bit difficult and could be used against the genuine criticism also, and could be used as a tool to curb the freedom of expression of citizens who want to raise the voice of dissent in a reasonable and fair way. So these are some of the aspects of contempt of court. I hope you have understood what exactly it means. Try to remember the constitutional provisions specifically, and try to remember the different kind of terminology that they have defined in the 1971 Act. Hope you have liked this video. For any doubt, please comment. Thank you.